caller just came in, and I want to share with you all special things. This extra special thing. Thank you, though, sent to you today holds more appreciation than any words can say. So words cannot express what I feel for you on my heart. I'm so glad to be a part of such a wonderful congregation. I can't thank you enough for the love and concern you all showed during our time of pain and grief at the death of my daughter. I will be forever grateful to you all. I pray God's blessing on each and every one forever and ever. For you are among the nicest people I have ever known. You'll never be forgotten for the thoughtfulness you show. Thanks for everything, Bobby Jackson and family. Her daughter funeralized, our homegoing service, and just came in, so I wanted to share that with the congregation. Thank God for Mother Jackson, amen. We also want to be reminded to continue to pray for Mother Franklin, Dancy family. Keep Captain Ray and Brother Dancy lifted up, President Todd family. And we thank God for the life and legacy of Mother Franklin, amen.
Amen.
We thank God for Mother Franklin Dancy, amen. And serving others, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. She would truly be missed. But we're reminded to keep that family lifted up in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
You know, it's a blessing to know I have known people that love the Lord.
Amen.
And because her word speaks for itself.
Right.
You know, she was a loving person, a kind person. She served the Lord and she served his people. Amen.
Amen.
So we thank God for her life and her legacy. Let us worship God this morning.
Amen.
Worship him in spirit and truth.
Amen.
Because he's our God, our Father.
Amen. Glory, glory, I pray.
Father, I just want to thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for this day. A day we have never seen. A day we'll never see again.
Amen.
Just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for coming together, my dear Father, and another try to give you some praise. Heavenly Father, you said just try, and you will be there. You said, my Heavenly Father, all you got to do is call on me. And you will appear. Then, my Heavenly Father, I want you to thank you. Thank you for our families this morning.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you for mothers and fathers.
Yes.
Thank you for sisters and brothers.
Yes.
My Heavenly Father, I come bow down on the knees this morning, my Heavenly Father, not knowing what to pray for.
Yes.
But my Heavenly Father, you said open your mouth and you were giving me the word.
Yes.
My Heavenly Father, because you got all power in the palm of your hand.
Yeah.
And you said, go. My Heavenly Father, all I got to do is just follow. My Heavenly Father, we try to get to the promised land.
Yeah.
My Heavenly Father, you sent your son down for us to be more like him.
Yeah.
To get to where he's at now.
Yeah.
He's sitting beside you, my Heavenly Father.
All right.
I just want to say thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you for what you have done for us. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for just understanding that we wouldn't gonna do everything right now. That's why you sent your son down. That's why you sent your son Jesus down. So we have a tree of life. Dear my Heavenly Father, I ask you to search our hearts this morning. My Heavenly Father, if you find anything like sin and confusion laying around it, my Heavenly Father, I ask you right now, move it. Move it to where it never rise again. And then I ask you to move it, my Heavenly Father. I ask you to cleanse our heart. My Heavenly Father, let us be more like Jesus. Let us want to live and walk the way that He did. Make us want to love one another while we can get together down here.
Yeah.
Praise your name.
Yeah.
Call on you.
Yeah.
Treat each other right.
Yeah.
To get to where
we're
trying to get, my Heavenly Father.
All
right. Then my Heavenly Father, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for our late laying down last night. And as you watched over us as we slumber last night, you just touched us one more time. You let us rise one more time. You didn't have to do it, but you did anyway. You know, we don't deserve it, but my Heavenly Father, you see otherwise. You said you're not finished with us down here. We got work to do. We got to treat one another right. We got to love on one another. We got to be able to speak to our enemies. Uplift our enemies, my Heavenly Father. And then we just got to love one another.
Yeah.
So that's what your son did when he came down.
Yeah.
He was loved.
Oh, yeah.
He was loved.
Oh, yeah.
He loved everything.
Yeah.
Everything, my Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
And then, my Heavenly Father, I'm praying for the sick this morning. I ask you to bless them. My Heavenly Father, I don't know name by name, but you do, my Heavenly Father, because you know it out. You got it all in the palm. You just look at it. And then you can just take it. And you give the ones what need it, when they need it, how they need it, and how much they need it, my Heavenly Father. I'm calling on you right now, Jesus. I'm calling on you to help us right now. We got so much going on down here. We got more going on. My Heavenly Father, I know you know about it. But my Heavenly Father, I know you're all in control. Come and say you don't ever leave us or forsake us. You'll never bring us up to nothing that works. You don't leave us, my Heavenly Father. I just want to say thank you. Who would serve a God like you? Who would serve a God like you? Who would want to talk to somebody like you? My Heavenly Father, God,
Start me on my way. Gave me my We said, to give you consolation this morning. Philippians, the fourth chapter. And we want you to look at, I'm going to start reading from the fourth verse. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Paul is talking to the Philippians about God. It says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand.
Yes, Lord.
Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer, supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known unto God. In the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your heart in mind through Christ Jesus. Finally, brother, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on the Lord. Think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do. The Lord of peace shall be what? With you. Thank God. Thank God.
Thank you.
Social media, we thank God for you as well. We just thank God for who He is. He's an awesome God. It's always good to see you. Amen. It ought to be an excitement and joy with brothers and sisters. Lift up the name of the Lord. Amen. We don't have to come in here fussing and fighting. We can come in here on one accord, loving one another, praising God. Amen. Amen. If I could, I'd like to invite your attention to the book of Psalms. 136 number of Psalms. 136 number of Psalms. I want to read one verse for this Psalm. That's verse 4. Psalms 136, verse 4. You found it, let it be known by saying amen.
Amen.
You need us to wait a minute. Amen. Amen. I'm reading from the King James Version, and also I want to read it from the NIV and also the ESV. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. King James says, to him alone doeth great wonders, for his mercy endureth forever. From the NIV, to him who alone does great wonders, his love endures forever. From the ESV, to him who alone does great wonders, for his steadfast love endures forever. Thank you, seated this morning in the presence of the Lord. I want to talk this morning for this thought. The goodness and the greatness of our God. The goodness and the greatness of our God. Let us pray. Gracious Father, we thank you. We thank you for this day that you have blessed us to come and to worship you. Father, we come realizing it's not about us.
Amen.
It's all about you.
Yes.
Father, this morning I call on you because I stand in need of your help. And I know you're very present help in the time of need. So I thank you this morning. Lord, I don't come for shape, form, or fashion.
Yes.
I come as humble as I know how.
Yes.
Leaning and depending on you.
Yes.
To use me how you see fit to use me. Lord, I'm thankful for all that you've done and all that you've done and all that you will do. Now, Lord, I ask right now, Holy Spirit,
Have your way. Holy Spirit, have your way. Holy Spirit, have your way. I beg you this morning to have your way, because I'm frail and I'm weak. I make mistakes, but I call on you, Holy Spirit, have your way. And I ask it all in the mighty, wonderful, sufficient name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 The goodness and the greatness of our God.
Yeah.
Only those who know the Lord, who have a relationship with the Lord, know that He's good and that He's great.
Amen.
And those of us that know Him, we put all our trust in Him.
Yeah, yeah.
But the person that does not know God doesn't know the goodness and the greatness of God. Because the last time I checked, God is the giver and sustainer of all life.
Amen.
You didn't just appear in this world. You didn't have the power to create yourself. You see, you have to understand, where there's nothing, nothing cannot create anything. But we serve a God who created all things. Everything that is breathing, God gives life to. I didn't have the power to give life. And I'm glad that God didn't put it in our hands to give life, because we'll let people die because we have problems with them. We don't agree with them. I'm glad that God is in control. And this 136th number of Psalm, the psalmist, in verse 1, he's calling the congregation to worship. And if you go back and look at 134th number of Psalms, it talks about praise.
Yeah.
Okay. And even you go on into 135, it talks about praise and who you ought to praise. We don't praise idols. We don't praise these false gods. That's all the psalmist was saying, that our praise ought to be to God. Not to man, not to things, but to God. That's why our praise ought to be aimed. Because I understand, if we praise God, God blesses. Anybody standing in need of a blessing this morning? Anybody standing in the need of blessing this morning? I know I stand in the need of God's blessing. I need God's hand on me. I need God to lead me, to guide me, to hold me when the storms come. I need Him this morning. But He says in verse 1, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord." Because verses 1 through 4 is just a call to worship, to lift up God. Because we praise Him for who He is. We notice it says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endureth forever." And if you know, when you read through these verses, after every statement that is made, it says, "For His mercy endureth forever, or His loving kindness endureth forever." How many know God is an always loving God? That His love never stops. No matter how bad you are, God's love never stops for you.
That's right.
Oftentimes our love stops when people have wronged us. But God love never stops. I don't care what you done got yourself into. God still loves you. He just don't like the sin that you're in. That you keep doing, but he still loves you. I don't care who you are. I don't care how dirty your garment is, God. God still loves you this morning. Even those that have not came to him, have not accepted his son, he still loved them. It's a, for God so loved the world. As we understand that God is love. You do know that, that God is love. We see in verse 1 that he is Jehovah. God, God. Jehovah God. He loves all of us. And I want you to understand that there's nothing that you can do that will stop God from loving you. But God do calls us to be obedient. So, in that verse 1, Jehovah, the covenant-keeping God, he was just telling the congregation at this time that God is a covenant-keeping God. He instituted a covenant to his people.
Yeah.
Meaning that he chose the Jews. Because if you see, look at Psalms 135, verse 4, he says, for the Lord had chosen Jacob unto himself and Israel for his peculiar treasure.
Yeah.
God made the covenant. Not because they were living right. Not because they were without sin. Because God chose them. God chose them. And I want to let you know this morning, God chose you. I'm glad that we serve a God that's not a covenant breaker. If God said it, God's going to do it. Verse 2, we see also, he said, oh, give thanks unto the God of gods. That he is supreme ruler over all. I don't care who's in position. When I look at this thing, God places people in position. You may be the owner of a successful company. You may be president of the country, but I know there's a higher power. And that power is God. Whoever he puts in position, it was God that appointed it. It was God that allowed it to happen. Even when we look at the evil kings that God allowed to be in position, even pagan kings that he used, God put them in power.
Yeah.
But all of us have to answer to a higher power.
Yeah.
And that higher power is God.
Yeah.
It says also in verse 3, oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords. He is the sovereign over all who hold places. God is sovereign. God can do anything that he so desires. Because this is his world. I know it says that this world is a Satan world, but he had to allow Satan a position. Just like you and I, he has given us a position, and that's to be children of God. Oh, I'm glad that I can call him Abba Father. I'm glad I can call him Daddy. Yeah, when I need him, I can call on him. I'm quite sure you know if you need him, all you have to do is call on him. That what Deacon Horton said this morning, if you need him, just call him. And I declare God an answer. It might not be on your time, but it's right on time. Earlier I said that only those who worship God is those who are peculiar. Meaning that you are strange. The world looking at us as we strange. We are strange. Because I no longer live the way I used to live. Or I had a lot of friends that walked off because I was strange. I'm quite sure y'all had some friends that walked off because y'all became strange. Psalms 1, let me find it. Verse 4. When he said that he had chosen them. Aren't you glad he didn't stop choosing? Because I find in 1 Peter 2 and 9, it says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, strange people. That you should show forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. And then Titus chapter 2 verse 14 says, who gave himself for us, talking about Jesus, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar, strange people. Zealous for good works. I'm glad that I'm strange. I'm glad that I'm different than the world. I'm glad that when somebody look at me, they can say, that's a brother or that's a sister in Christ. Because how we live, we're very different from the world. At least we ought to be different from the world. Yeah, he calls them to worship. What did we come to do this morning? What did we come to do this morning? Did we come in here just to say we came? How did we come here to give God all the glory, all the honor, and all of the praise? Don't leave none of it out. Give it all to him this morning. Deacon Horton said he don't care who's looking at him. If you got to get up there, he loves you. Yeah, if you have to run, go ahead and run. If you need to scream to the top of your voice, go ahead and scream. And when somebody asks, what's wrong with you? Say, I was giving it all to the Lord. I come to worship. In spite of what's going on in my life, I come to worship this morning. I may not do it like you. I may not do it like you, but I'm going to give it all. Trip and fall. Lord, forgive me. Pick me back up. Help me get on my feet and run for you. But he was reminding them why he was calling them to worship. Verses 5 through 9, we see the God of creation. You remember Genesis, when it was dark and void, it was nothing. And said, God hovered over the waters. And God said, let there be light. God spoke these things into existence. He said in verse 5, he made the heavens. You and I had no part in making the heaven. That just lets me know God had us in mind already. That's a loving God. He had us in mind already before we were even thought of. God already knew us. God was speaking a world into existence to house his people. Isn't God good this morning? Yeah, verse 6 said he stretched out the earth above the waters. But there was no land. God said, land, come on in. I'm going to place you on top of the waters. Stand now. God is sustaining everything. A God that can position the planets in the midst of a vast expanse and hold all things together. That lets me know he can hold me. He can hold you through whatever storm you may have to face in your life. We serve an awesome God. He says in verse 7 through 9 that he made the great lights. The sun to rule by day. The moon and the stars to rule by night. We serve a great architect. Ain't he good? The Lord is so good. Oh, he sets the atmosphere where we can breathe. If it's all just a little bit, we'll all die. But God is holding all things together. Yeah, he set the sun in his place, the moon and the stars in his place. Give him some praise this morning. That's all the song that we say. Give him some praise. Because he is the God of creation. Did not he make you and I in his image and in his likeness? Did he do it? Everybody ought to want to praise God. Everybody ought to want to praise God. All of us should be praising Him. Those that don't know Him, we have to live a life that they can see the Christ in us. That will make them wonder about us. What's going on with these strange people? We ought to live in such a way that they come and ask us about our strangeness, about how we act, how we treat people that taught us wrong, that have done us wrong. We know that even our ancestors was in slavery. They were in slavery. They were beaten, killed, hung from trees. But God still had those of our ancestors that would trust him, that would follow him. They did not give up hope in God. Even though they were treated like nothing, but yet they still trusted in a God that could deliver. I understand many died, but they didn't lose no battles because they knew the Lord. They had a relationship with the Lord. Yeah, it was wrong the way they was treated, but they trusted God. They kept their focus on God. They praised God. You and I, we're not being beaten. Where's our praise this morning? When I look at God, when they said that black people couldn't vote, it was a struggle, but it happened. You weren't able to own your own business, but God allowed it to happen. You shouldn't be at this job making this amount of money, but God allowed it to happen. You shouldn't be sitting in this seat, in this job, on this board, but God allowed it to happen. I see skin color in high position, and they ought to know who put them there. It was the God of heaven that put them where they are. You weren't supposed to be able to save enough money to retire, but God changed that. Didn't do it. He served an awesome church this morning. We drove. Verses 10 through 15, he's the God of deliverance. We know about the children of Israel. They were in Egypt. How they got to Egypt to the brother sold that younger brother into slavery. God was working it all out. Y'all know we've been talking about it in Bible study. Yeah, Joseph was sold into slavery. But you know the thing I like about it? It said, and God was with him. Ain't it good to know that God is with you? I know it looked bad. I know it had to hurt Joseph that his brother sold him into slavery. But it was all God's plan. Yeah, they sold him into slavery. But even after he was lied on, he was in prison. But the text tells us that and God was with him. No matter where you are, you may be at the bottom of the barrel, but I tell you this morning, God is with you. Can he sustain you even at the bottom as well as he can at the top? God is everywhere at all times. If you are his child, he's with you. You may be in harm's way, but God is with you. Death may be riding your back, but God is with you.
Yes, he is. Yes, he
is. Joseph, after he came from the prison, he went to the palace because of God's favor on his life. I want to tell you this morning, you ought to praise him because his favor is on your life this morning. God's favor is on your life. I know you may have a few aches and pains. I know everything may not be going good on the job, may not be going good in your home. Oh, we hear a lot of bad news, but I want to let you know that God's favor is still on your life. Yeah, God's favor is on your life this morning. You may get a job and it's getting rough. But I want to tell you, God's favor is on you this morning. God won't take you somewhere that he can't keep you. And then after he sees fit, he'll move you somewhere else. Move you somewhere else better. Won't he do it? Is anybody a witness? But God has blessed me so tremendously. It stunned me when they offered me. Somebody didn't even know anything about the job. It was just all in God's plan. That's why I know God is real. Because I was smart enough, I knew enough, or who I knew. It was all in God's plan. He just used me to get me to where he wanted me to be. Have you ever been there? Have you ever been there? You struggled for a while, but God was still sustaining you in your struggles. Sometimes God, he'll let us go through the struggles so we can appreciate him when he blesses us. So I'm appreciate him in the struggles, and I'm going to appreciate when he raises me up. When you're praising this morning, you may not be where you want to be, but thank God for where you are this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
Joseph was known in Egypt. He was known. But it says, after Joseph had died out, there was a new pharaoh that didn't know Joseph. I don't believe it that it was that he didn't know him. It was just that he seemed to multiply of the nation. And he got fearful. And he put them under heavy taskmasters. And served for over 400 years. But he says that the children began to cry out. They began to cry out. God's going to deliver them by the name of Moses. Go and tell Pharaoh to let my children go. But y'all know the story. Pharaoh had a hard heart. But I like I said, you may be in position of power, but I know a God that can overrule you. God can speak a man to lay down and die. God can speak a man to get up and leave. Do you remember Ezekiel? He asked these dry bones, can they live? Only you know, Lord, because God has all power. You may be dead this morning, but you can be alive this morning if you know him. Give your life to him. Notice he says he smote Egypt in their firstborn. All because Pharaoh had a hard heart. He brought Israel from among them. You remember the Exodus? But God was bringing them out of Egypt. It says, with a strong hand and with a stretched out arm. God is strong. God is able to deliver you from anything that you're going through. God delivered me from me. Because I was a wreck. I was messed up. Had no hope. I just said, wasn't fit to live, and so wasn't fit to die. But I'm glad he delivered me. All of us been delivered from sin. Yeah, didn't God do it? I'm so glad this morning that he delivered me from sin. Look at God. He made a pathway through the Red Sea. And it said, and the Israelites passed through. He's the best GPS that you can have. Every now and then, your GPS will lead you to a place that you weren't looking for. Sometimes they malfunction. Sometimes they stop working. And if you unplug them long enough, they'll die out. But we serve a God that neither sleep nor slumber. He doesn't get tired. He doesn't get weary. He doesn't get weak. He's strong. He's strong. Do you know he's strong? Not only that, as he was taking them on the pathway through the Red Sea, there was an army behind them. But look at God, the great deliverer. As they made it through, the Egyptians, they went through dry ground too. But all of a sudden, the ground began to get wet because the walls of water began to close up on them. Didn't God do it? Yeah, sin was closing in on us. Oh, look at Jesus step down and missed our sin. Look at him. Ain't a good God. He stepped down in this earth, born of a virgin. Did he do it? Look at Jesus stepping down on our behalf. Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad this morning that Jesus came down for you and for me? You ought to wave your hand. In verses 16 through 25, the God of provision. The God of provision. Oh, I know God is a great provider. God never stops providing.
That's right.
We may feel like we don't have all we should have. But God is still providing for you. I hadn't been all I should have been. But I tell you what, he woke me up this morning. Y'all know how we say he started me on my way. Yeah, I was able to put one foot in front of the other. I had the activity of my legs. He woke me up in my right mind this morning. My mind ought to be stayed on him. Your mind ought to be stayed on him. Praise him this morning. The goodness and the greatness of our God. That's all the psalmist is doing, reminding them they need to praise God. For he is the creator. Yeah, he is our deliverer. He also is our provider. He has brought them out of Egypt. Their rebellion, their stubbornness, took 40 years. 40 years. It should have been only a 3-day journey. But because of that disobedience, their rebellion, their stubbornness. Are we like that sometimes? Are we like that sometimes? But yet, he's still bringing us. It says while they was in the wilderness for those 40 years, their clothes did not wear out. Their sandals did not wear out. God was steady providing. And when they were hungry and they began to complain, he fed them bread from heaven, manna. Then he added a little something on to it. He added a little meat within the point. God is a provider. Have you ever been there when bills were so exceeded your paycheck? But God still provided. Have you ever mishandled your money? But God still provided. Yeah, God is a great provider. There's food on your table every single day. There's clothes on your back every single day. Yeah, he keeps on making a way out of no way. I can imagine that when they got to the Red Sea, a vast, great vast of water and a great army behind them, not realizing that they were serving a great and awesome God. A God that's bigger than the Red Sea. A God that's bigger than the Egyptian army. It's a God that holds the world in his hand. He said in his hand, the world is standing on God's word. All you gotta do is speak. Who would serve a God like that? Who would serve a God like that? Give us this day our daily bread. God's been feeding us. He's going to continue to feed us. Past, present, and future. God got you this morning. God has each and every one of us in the palm of his hand. Aren't you glad to know that you're in his hand? And can't nothing, no wonder. Pluck you out of God's hand. God is too powerful for anybody to move you. Don't worry about your position on the job. Because if God don't want you moved, I don't care how bad the boss got it in for you. If God ain't ready for you to go, don't worry. But when he's ready for you to go, tell him, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity, but my God is moving me on. Give us some praise this morning. None of us had any hope. We were all lost. Couldn't pay our way out. Couldn't run fast enough to get out. Couldn't talk enough to get out. Couldn't plead enough to get out. But I'm so glad that Jesus came on the scene. That we was rooted in, grounded in. We find ourselves now rooted, grounded in Him. Tied up, tangled in Jesus. Ain't you glad this morning that Jesus came? Didn't He come? He came to see about you and I. God is a great provider. Abraham couldn't do it. Moses couldn't do it. David couldn't do it. Even though he was a great warrior, he couldn't do it. Isaiah couldn't do it. Ezekiel couldn't do it. None of the prophets could do it. None of his apostles could do it. But they were standing on the great cornerstone, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Lily of the Valley, the bright and the morning star, the Prince of Peace, the bread of life. Yes, it's Jesus. His name is Jesus. The one that we sing out on the hill. Pastor, hold up. I didn't see him out there on Golgotha Hill, but my faith tells me with spiritual eye, I can see my Lord and my Savior hanging on an old rugged cross. Yes, He's hanging there for you and for me. Didn't He die? He died. Didn't the Lord die? Yes, He died. He died. I tell you, He died. That's all right. They said they took Him down, buried Him in the buckle of tomb. Oh, that's all right. I know everybody back then was sad. Howdy, I was a disciple. But that's all right. That's all right. They even ran off and left Him. But that's all right. He died. He died. He was in a buckle of tomb. But you know what? You know what? You know what? You know what? Do you know what? Right early, right early, right early. Sunday morning, my Jesus, your Jesus, got up with all power, heaven and earth in His hand, and in life to all that will believe. Do you know Him? Do you know Him this morning? I talk about God's Son, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Came to give eternal life.
That's the love of God. The love of God. His love. His mercy. His grace. His faithfulness. It's toward all of us. Even those that are unsaved. All you have to do is call on him this morning. Call on his son again. Let it into your heart. He says, he stands at the door and he knocks. Anyone that opens, he'll come in and sup with you. There may be somebody in the sanctuary this morning that don't have a relationship with Jesus. You can come this morning. No need to leave here the same way you came. Even us as saints, we don't need to leave the same way you came. If you came for worship, leave with worship. Amen. There may be somebody that's beautiful. God loves you. God loves you so much that he gave his only begotten son, and all our sins were placed on Jesus to redeem us from sin and death and hell. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. If you don't know Jesus before you leave this world, you'll spend eternity in hell, separated from him. And it's a hell go into the lake of fire. We go through so much here. Why live in hell? Then go to hell. You can come this morning. Because God knows. I don't care how bad you've been. God loves you. Don't feel that you've been so bad that God can't save you. But God spoke this world into existence. A God that delivered the children of Israel out of Egypt. A God that delivered our ancestors out of slavery. A God that parted the Red Sea. We can't even part a little stream. But God can speak and divide a vast sea. That lets me know he can save me. Nobody's out of his saved grace. He's able. He's able. He's able. I see that there is none. May God bless you and may God keep you. God is good. Circumstances, but we have to be reminded of the goodness and the greatness of our God. Amen. And I think now we'll have amen. Amen.
Hey, Brother John, before they come, I'd like to remind all our members on next Sunday morning at 8:30 we'll start our in-house Sunday school. I have some books here, and we want to thank Sister Teresa Nelson. Said that she will make sure that we have copies of our lesson each week in case we didn't go by book number of books that we ordered.
Amen.
So we just want to thank her for that. And also we want to make sure our youth know that there will be someone here to teach them in the fellowship hall next Sunday also.
Amen. 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 Thank you. Amen. Let's give these girls a hand.
safeguard me. Let go. All right. See, we're free. All right. St. Andrew PB Church, where Elder Buford Moore III is pastor, is located at 1393 Swancott Road, Madison, Alabama, 35756.